Anger, Part 14. Suryaben and Alpa.
Jay Sachidanan, my question is, here, many people have taken naan, but they...
You mean in Kenya?
Yes, in Kenya.
Everyone's here. You mean the ones that are not sitting here, the outsiders.
Many people in Kenya have taken naan. However, many of them don't come for satsangs or for the spiritual retreats. They have taken naan once, but they don't go anywhere. So they won't be able to progress further. So what about them?
Say if we've given 500,000 rupees to a person, and if we say he's not using it at all, he'll use it the day he needs it. That valuable money will come in handy. It won't go to waste. This seed has been sown. It'll grow someday. When the merit karma of a million lifetimes comes into effect, then one is able to come near the Gnani. And when a million merit karmas multiplied by a million come into effect, then he's able to attain Gnan. If people have some obstructing karma, then some will attain Jagruti after 2 days, some will attain it after 2 years, some will attain it after 20 years, but it'll definitely come. He will get the link from somewhere.
If I tell them the Gnani Purush has arrived here today, please come, then the reply is, I have taken naan once. What is the need of going there again?
We can say, when you admitted your child in school, say if you've taken admission in a medical school, is there any need to go to college every day? You can ask these businessmen here. Do they only go once a year for their business to run? Do you say, I've started a business, what is the need to go every day? Hey, if you don't go every day, then you won't make a profit. If they comment in this manner, then we should say, well, this Gnan is attained through grace. So on occasions when the Gnani comes, you should take advantage of that. Then your Jagruti will increase. You'll gain the understanding of how to become free from attachment, abhorrence, and illusory attachment. They may say, no, but we've already taken Gnan. In reality, that person doesn't want to come. Therefore, he's arguing. Therefore, we should recognize his intent that he's not interested. So, we shouldn't bother him. We can say, you can come whenever you have time. If you have time, then come someday. He'll say yes, yes. Then, we should close the chapter. We should make him say yes instead of no, and then close the chapter.
Okay, Jay Sachidanand.
It'll grow for sure. Sooner or later, it will grow for sure. The other person may be following his previous religion or may have a guru. He may think, how can I leave my religion? Moreover, he feels, I understood that here they're talking about the self. They're good talks. That's it. He does not understand anything else. I'm binding karmas through attachment abhorrence. My liberation has been blocked. Only if these kshayas are dissolved will I be able to attain liberation. He does not have such deep understanding. If he had such understanding, then he would not leave. They'll come back later. I've seen many people who come after 5, 10, 20 years. They wander for some time and then they come here. They say, I investigated everywhere, but I did not find anything. And then if he gets this link, you may be telling that person, but if his niece or some close relative tells him, then he says, yes, I've attended the satsang of Dada Bhagwan. The relative will say, it's the ultimate thing. Then he'll say, oh yes, I've taken Gnan a long time back, in the year 1997. In this way, he joins back. We say, come and sit in this compartment. Your ticket is considered valid. We never consider it canceled. There, if one does not sit in the train on time, then they cancel the tickets. Whereas here, if one comes even after 5 years, we allow the ticket. We say, even if you don't have the physical ticket, come and sit. One says, I've lost the ticket. Then we ask, did you buy a ticket previously? He'll say, yes, I had bought one. Then we say, come on, come on, come inside. However, eventually it will grow. It's because they have other problems, so...
They will come someday.
Yes, they will come. They've brought obstructing karmas with them. The effect of the past life karmas are such that one has even brought obstructing karmas. One attains the gnan, but also has obstructing karmas. For example, these businessmen have lots of businesses. They earn tens of millions of rupees. However, they have obstructing karmas for enjoying it. If we ask, "What do you eat?" he'll say, "I eat an apple in the afternoon, some millet bread, and cook vegetables in the evening. I cannot eat butter. The doctor has asked me not to." It's obvious he has brought obstructing karmas for enjoying it. House helpers freely eat it with butter spread on it. They have rosy cheeks like red tomatoes.
Jay Sachidanand.
What can be done? Alpa and Bharat Kumar.
Jay Sachidanand, yesterday I heard about the talk of irritation due to snoring. It is such a common problem, so I want to know about snoring.
Is it that you snore and people are miserable?
Yes.
Oh, there's no solution for that. This is because after we sleep, then our snoring starts. After we wake up, we say, "Oh, when did I ever snore?"
But if I know my weakness and if other people become miserable through that, then...
Then you should sleep in a room with the doors closed so that nobody can hear the noise. There's no other remedy for it. The people who are listening to the snoring, if you're the one who is snoring, then people next to you will gradually get used to it. Then if you don't snore, the person beside you won't be able to sleep. He may think, "Why is she not snoring today? Has something happened to her?" He'll softly shake you and ask, "Are you feeling okay? Actually, I wasn't able to sleep since you weren't snoring." He's habituated with the snoring. If you snore, only then he'll be able to sleep.
It is said at home, but when I go outside in such retreats, then due to me...
Then you should find out who are the people who have a habit of snoring. Put all of those four people in one room. So the musical concert can go on the entire night. What else can be done? Otherwise, give them the last room so that at least half of them can sleep peacefully. We need to prepare a form for that.
So this thing, is it due to the food or is it a natural thing?
I don't know about that. We'll have to ask a doctor about it. Some people say people who are overweight, only they snore. However, even the skinny ones snore. So we don't know whom to accuse. This is an experienced person talking. As the fat decreases, meaning the fat of the body, as the fat of the body decreases, and when it decreases from the throat, then the snoring stops.
My second question is, if I have kept the idol of Lord Simandhar Swami at home, but if I don't go to the Jain temple anymore, then am I committing any fault in that?
No, it's not like that. And if circumstances arise where all of them are going and if you have to go, even then there's no problem in that. If file one goes, then it's good. And if she does not go, even then there's no problem. And if she goes, even then there's no problem. You should say, "File one, go do some nice devotional viewing of the Lord." If it's a Sunday or some festival, then you can go on such occasions and on holidays. Then people will feel she's following the religion. She hasn't gone wayward. Also, when you go to a temple, there's a life instilled in the Lord. As thousands of people do devotional viewing of the Lord, we can go there in peace. We should not spoil our intent. We should not have the intent that it's not worth going to the temple. There's no problem if we don't go. We don't commit any fault. However, we can go on festivals like Diwali when we're free for the entire day. We can go in the morning. We can say, "Let's go today. Let's do some nice devotional viewing of the Lord. Let's take the blessings of the Lord. I want to attain moksha. I want to become a non-doer and become vitrag like you." What does it mean by the posture of the omniscient Lord? The Lord is sitting with his hands and legs folded and his eyes closed. It's not worth doing anything. It's not from the outside, it's from the inside. You should make the ego sit in the seat of the pure soul. Whatever the body is doing from the outside is according to Vyavasthit. That much, you should let it happen. Now the doership has been handed over to Vyavasthit. We should go for the devotional viewing of the Lord to understand this.
Even before, we used to occasionally go, but since we have brought the idol, then I...
Yes, but then you do the devotional viewing of Lord Simandar Swami in the morning, don't you?
Yes, I do it at home.
That's fine. It'll do. There's no problem. Bharat Kumar. Madhu.
I realize that I am seeing faults of others. I realize that he is just instrumental in the process. I am not able to see the pure soul immediately. I know that he is instrumental in the process. Then is that considered as seeing through the intellect or through jnana?
But we don't have any suffering within, do we?
Sometimes it clicks about the suffering, but it does not happen always.
If we see the other person as instrumental in the process, then that's fine. We're not seeing faults in the other person. It's indeed referred to as jnana. It has started through the direct light of the self. It is Jagrati. If there is a fault in the other person, then we'll be able to see that. Say, if there's a neem tree, then we know that it's bitter, but we don't have any attachment or abhorrence towards it. We can identify the intrinsic nature, the swabhav, of the non-self complex or the pudgal.
Yes, I am able to know that.
The intellect will show us, but we don't have any attachment or abhorrence for that through jnana. Therefore, it's cleared.
So, is it the intellect which shows this person is just instrumental in the process? Or, because I am not able to see the pure soul at that time?
Yes, it'll do. If any jnana remains present at that time, even if one of the agnas remains present, then that is considered as remaining in jnana. We should understand that it remained present through the direct light of the self.
All right. Secondly, Dada did not like the I-ness. Kindly give some examples for that.
His I-ness had dissolved completely. The day he attained jnana, that very day his I-ness dissolved. He did not like it at all before jnana. He was fed up of it. He found it as bitter as poison. Some people prevail as a husband, don't they?
Yes, it happens.
People prevail as a father. They act bossy. People prevail in many different states of doership, don't they? The various states of doership, the I-ness is at a very subtle level. However, at the gross level too, people prevail in many states. They prevail as a father, as a business partner. The I-ness is at a subtle level.
At that time, does the Jagrati move aside?
Yes. When one becomes engrossed with file one, at that time, the I-ness is indeed there. The Jagrati moves away and a lack of awareness prevails. At that time, the I-ness is surely there. What is I-ness? If someone says, don't sit in the front, go and sit in the back, then do you get restless from within? When you feel insulted, at that time your I-ness, the ego, is instigated. What's your problem? Does this chair belong to you? I can sit anywhere I like. Who are you to tell me to get up? Therefore, when the ego is instigated, that ego is considered I-ness. If someone says, go sit in the back, then we should tell file one, come on, file one, go sit in the back, let's go. If you had come 10 minutes later and got a seat in the back, then would you not feel happy? He sent that person upstairs. At least I was able to sit downstairs. We feel happy about it, don't we? Similarly, we should remain positive. It's good that he sent me to the back and not upstairs. That's great. When the ego feels suffering within, then that ego is the ego of the I-ness. You are a pure soul. But why does it still affect you? This is because I'm file one still prevails. We should remain as the knower of that part. Hey, file one, settle it with equanimity. Whatever has happened is vyavasthit. It's not his fault. That much I-ness will dissolve.
It does not come immediately at that time.
It comes after some time, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
It comes within half an hour, doesn't it?
It comes before that.
See? Then that's considered good Jagrati. The unfolding of the karma comes with a force. When it dies down, at that time the Jagrati arises. And if we clean it up, then that much of the fault dissolves.
When anger arises at that time, what is the situation of the internal functioning mechanism of the mind, intellect, chit, and ego, or antaskaran?
It becomes unstable. The intellect sees, this person spoiled the work, straighten him out. When the intellect sees it, then the ego loses its temper and creates turmoil. He'll get upset at that person. Why? Who did you ask before doing it? Don't you have any sense? don't touch it, just go away. Therefore, the intellect and ego create turmoil. And then the mind and chit are also joined in that. So the antaskaran becomes completely blind. The jagrati within gets exhausted. One does not have the awareness of what he's doing.
Don't other thoughts arise in the mind at that time?
At that time, the person is in a state of kashai. So the thoughts are related to that matter. This person spoiled the work. These kinds of people shouldn't be recruited. Who sent him inside? He'll go talk to a third person. This person spoiled the work. How did he get in? Why did he spoil the work? His mind keeps working on that. The mind, intellect, chit, and ego create turmoil. Therefore, blindness arises in the state of kashai. It's referred to as blindness. He's not able to have awareness of what is beneficial and what is harmful. He doesn't understand that whatever I'm doing is wrong. In the case of our Mahatmas, the jagruti comes after some time. Whether the work got spoiled or improved, why did I hurt the other person? He immediately starts repenting and starts doing pratikraman. Therefore, after attaining this gnan, the jagruti comes in a short while. The frozen stock of ice-like karmas erupts, but when the situation arises, and then when the situation is about to end, before that, the jagruti arises and one repents a lot and washes off the fault. Do you understand?
The worldly life is due to the beliefs of the kashai-laden believer, or bhavo. After attaining jnana, changes arise in the bhavo, don't they?
Yes. Changes arise in the bhavo.
Then why do the changes not occur in the physical body complex or mangaldas?
It's the frozen stock of karma. It's discharging by giving its effect. That's not going to improve. Now the belief can change. The wrong beliefs gradually keep dissolving and reach the interim state of the self with the right belief. This mangaldas gradually becomes natural and spontaneous.
So the mangaldas keeps becoming natural and spontaneous, doesn't it?
It remains the same. The neem tree will not become a mango tree. The bitterness, the bitter juice part, has dissolved. However, the appearance will remain the same. The mangaldas remains the same. The age keeps increasing, the hair turns gray, and the number of teeth decrease. All of that will happen.
Yes, it is in its swabhav.
The skin becomes loose gradually. You won't see any changes in that. It's the part that's frozen. The changeable part is the bhavo. The degree of the bhavo gradually increases through the understanding of the gnan. It'll keep increasing from 300 degrees to 301, 302. It gradually becomes the interim state of the self with the right belief, the gnani bhavo. At 345 degrees, he's considered a gnani. At 355 degrees, he reaches the state of God. And at 360 degrees, he becomes the fully enlightened one. So, the state of the bhava will gradually keep rising higher, and the mangaldas will remain as it is. We used to have the belief of I-ness in that. Now we have become free from that. We came into the intermediate, awakened state. The mangaldas remains as it is.
For the jagrati of the bhava, we have to do the real spiritual effort of the five agnas.
Yes, the five agnas. We should remain in this satsang. If there's no retreat or satsang, then we can read books at home, we can watch videos, we can do the vidhis. We can do vidhi, reading, samayik, pratikraman. All of these are helpful in following the five agnas.
Explain the swabhav of the eternal elements.
Which eternal elements, swabhav, do you want to understand?
The element of the self is indeed in the form of knowledge.
Yes. This is knowledge. And then there's ignorance of the self. There is the inherent nature, or swabhav. And there's the extra intent of I am Chandubhai, or vibhav. It sways between the two. Its swabhav is such that vibhav can also arise. It just needs another element for the vibhav to arise. Then he, the I, sees it. Who did it? The I believes that I did it. That is why vibhav arises. Moreover, the inanimate matter, or jar, is such that, as the vibhav of the self arises, it becomes that form.
It is in the form of subatomic particles, or parmanus.
It becomes that form. Say if there's a mirror, then the exact reflection of your face will arise in that. If the other person comes, then the exact reflection of his face will arise in that. You'll say, the mirror is very powerful. Whatever comes, it catches the reflection of that. No, actually it is its swabhav to show the reflection. Whereas when the reflection is formed, then we know it within that it happened in this way. Say if there are two mirrors, then the reflections will fall on each other. Similarly, the function of the self is to know, and here the reflection is formed based on the intents that arise. The self can also change the intents. When the self changes the intent, then the reflection changes accordingly. If we're standing in front of a mirror and we make faces, then the reflections keep changing there. One thinks that the mirror is doing it. No, it's not. Its swabhav is like that. Now, the ego is the one within that's changing the intents. I want to go here and go there. First, it is the intent of the ego that arises within. Then the reflection changes on the face. Thereafter, the reflection of that falls on the mirror.
The self has nothing to do with it, right?
Everything happens in the illumination of the self. Just as in the illumination of the light, if there's no light in the room, then will you be able to see my face? First, I'll turn on the lights, then I'll look in the mirror. How do I look? Then I'll comb my hair. You have less, so you'll comb it from the sides. Even if there's no hair, you'll fix your hair for sure. You'll say, there's still 3 hairs left. We may think that we're doing this, but we're not. The ego of file one combs the hair of file one. You remain as the knower that file one combed his hair. Do you understand? The games of the Bhavo and the Mangaldas go on. We should remain separate and keep seeing it.
I talk in front of the mirror many times.
Yes. We should talk and say, what's going on, Bharat Bhai? When we talk at that time, the self remains separate and gradually comes into the state of experience.
Sometimes I do the charanvidhi for half an hour in front of the mirror.
Yes, do it. The people at home aren't objecting, are they?
Right now, file one is the only one who stays there.
Then it's okay. Otherwise, your wife will say, oh, what are you blabbering in front of the mirror? Look, the children are watching you. They feel something is wrong with daddy. Therefore, we should do things that don't create drama. When we're alone, then we can do it properly by latching the door shut.
I can understand the swabhav of the eternal elements of motion, gati sayak, and inertia, sthiti sayak. However, what is the swabhav of the eternal elements of space, akash, and time, kal?
Who has given space to you? You'll say Piyush Bhai. No, it's actually Akash. Akash gave it to Piyush Bhai as well. Piyush Bhai grabbed the area from Akash. He says, the hall is ours. In that, whatever area you occupy, that is your Akash. The element of Akash gives space. Do you understand? No one else can sit in your place. When you get up, then someone else can come. At that time, the kal has changed. Therefore, in one space, one element and one soul is there. When another soul comes, then the kal has changed. Do you understand? Therefore, it is the giver of space. Based on Akash, if you're sitting here, then you can see this part in this way. And if you're sitting there, then you see something else. Therefore, an angle arises, a viewpoint arises. You see differently based on your viewpoint. What this person is able to see, you see differently. This is because you're sitting at this place. Therefore, the intents arise based on the location. Through intents, the Paramanus get charged. The charged Paramanus are different for each person. Yours are different and the other person's are different. And when they discharge, your face is different and this person's face is different. Based on different locations, the intents are different. Different karmas are bound and one has to suffer different effects for that. Do you understand? So the place plays a very important role. However, it's just an instrumental doer. Nobody is an independent doer. Nobody can say, I did everything.
In this antaskaran,
in all of this, it's worth understanding the swabhav of the putgal. Its swabhav is to be active. Say there's an hourglass. When you turn it upside down, then gradually a mound of sand forms. Gradually grows bigger from the center and then falls down from the sides. Now who formed this design? It's because the swabhav of jar is to be active. Moreover, whether the presence of the self is there or not, its activity perpetuates day and night. Sometimes there's high tide, it keeps increasing. And after some time, it becomes low tide, it keeps decreasing. The waves crash, and then they become quiet. That's considered activity.
Is it because it is an element with form? Jad is an element with form.
Because it's an element with form, it's visible. It's also active. The other five elements do not have such activity. Yes, the self has one specialty. The self can know the activity. Moreover, even if the self does not know it, the changes keep happening. Jad is active. The self can know it, the other five of them, the self and the other four eternal elements are invisible. Only Jad is the one with form and is active. To see that activity, we came to know about Akash based on the activity. When one Parmanu crosses another Parmanu, then we come to know about Akash. We come to know about Kaal as well. It's been 1 hour and this many Parmanus have shed off. Therefore, we come to know about Kaal. So we recognize Akash. Where the Parmanus occupy space, that is referred to as the Akash of the Parmanus. When one Parmanu crosses another Parmanu, then it is referred to as Kaal. Moreover, when it moves, we recognize Gati Sahayak. And when it becomes stable, then we recognize Sthiti Sahayak. And when we saw it, then we recognized the self. So in one element that has form, we can recognize all the other five elements. The others can be understood, and this one Jad can be known. The specialty of Jad is that when we are able to see it, then we can understand that the other five elements do exist. One says, I was here, now I moved here, I moved in this much time. We came to know that the space changed. The one who is the seer, that seer is our own element. In discharge, one gets the help of the other elements. The person is at one place at one time and at another place at another time. Therefore, Akash, Kaal, Gati Sahayak, Sthiti Sahayak, and Jad, and the seer is the self. Therefore, whenever we write a question, there's the Kaal when it's written. The knowledge of the writing is ours. The activity of the writing is of the Jad. The Kaal of the writing starts and the Kaal of the writing ends. Gati Sahayak, Sthiti Sahayak, and the place where we write. All six elements are joined in just one activity of writing. Do you understand? This is a very big chapter on the activity of the Parmanu in the book Aptvani 14. This is Dada's spectacular discovery. In the scriptures, there's a mixture of talks, whereas this is Dada's spectacular discovery that Jad is the only one with activity.
In the Antaskaran, we have the mind, the intellect, the chit, and the ego. Many times the intellect interferes a lot. One day there was a clip of Niruma on the internet. The topic was how to control the intellect. I understood it so nicely from that clip. Niruma said, when my intellect showed I do not want to talk to that person, then I used to go and talk to that person right away. It is so nicely said in all these clips, like in the Energizers. There is such nice understanding on the internet. I have benefited a lot from all that.
Yes, very nice.
There were some DVD parts being shown on the book The Flawless Vision. In that, part number 37, number 23, number 29 were very nice. Right now, the book Aptavani 6 is being shown. In that, satsang of the books Aptavani 1 and Aptavani 2 are also shown. There is one drawing which shows the journey from the state of the embodied soul to the state of 360 degrees. There is a drawing on the internet, but there is no physical copy available here. Even in Adalaj Center, it is not available.
What's not available? How the development takes place.
What are the stages of development?
No problem. Whatever we get to see, we should see that. This is because whatever we are able to see in the drawing, it is really many times more than that. The talks that come out in words are very gross and very limited. Therefore, the drawing really cannot do it justice. Moreover, it cannot be considered final.
It was there in your satsang. A visualization of that was depicted. However, I have not seen it anywhere outside.
If it's not there, then it's okay. We should understand it gradually. You understood the intellect, didn't you?
Yes, that is correct.
We should do the opposite of what it shows, so that we can move further towards Gnan. Jai Sachidanand.